Hey guys, welcome to this lesson. In this lesson, we'll create a simple microservice-based application using a REST API, AWS Lambda, and DynamoDB. So the application will look something like this. We'll be able to send post requests to our API, which will forward them through to the AWS Lambda compute backend. Lambda is then going to create an item in the DynamoDB table. So fairly straightforward. What we need to do is we need to create these elements and then link them all together. So let's head over to the console. So make sure you're logged into the AWS console. The first place we're going to go across to is IAM because we need to set up some permissions policies here. Now in the course download, you will find the Amazon API Gateway directory, then the API Lambda DynamoDB HOL markdown file. In here, you can see that the first task is to create a permissions policy in IAM, and we're going to call it Lambda API Gateway Policy. Now, what you can see here, this is going to be, of course, signed to our Lambda function to provide the function with the permissions it needs to create items in the DynamoDB table. So you can see there's a few DynamoDB API actions here, including get item and put item. There's also some permissions to CloudWatch logs as well. So let's copy all of this code and then head back to IAM, go to policies, create policy, and then flick to the JSON tab. We can delete all the existing code here and enter our code. Click on next. And now all we need to do here is provide a policy name. So we have a name up here, Lambda API Gateway Policy. I'll paste that in and then scroll down. And we can see it's telling us that we've got two services included in our permissions policy, CloudWatch logs and DynamoDB. So let's create the policy. We'll now create a role. So let's head across to roles and we're going to create a role. The trusted entity type will be an AWS service. This is going to be used for Lambda. So the use case is going to be Lambda. And then we can click on next. We can find our permissions policy, attach it, click on next, and then provide a name. And for this, I'm just going to change policy to role. So Lambda API Gateway role. And we can see that because of the selection we made on the first page, we have provided the trust policy so that the action STS assume role can be performed by Lambda. So that means that Lambda is able to assume the role and then will be assigned the permissions in the permissions policy. So we can go ahead and create the role. Next, what we need to do is head over to Lambda and we're going to create a function. And we have a name for our function here. So I'm just scrolling down now. This is task three. It's called Lambda function over HTTPS. So I can paste that in. Now we need to change here to Python. Just use the latest one, whatever that might be. And very importantly, we need to find our execution role. So let's find the role. And here we can see Lambda API Gateway role. So now the function will be created with the correct execution role that has the permissions to DynamoDB as well as CloudWatch logs. Next, we'll come back and we want to use this code. So here's the Python code. So I'll copy all of this code. I've got that on my clipboard. And I can come back to my function, paste all of that in, and then click on deploy. So I deleted any existing placeholder code in there and just added my custom code and deployed the function. Now at this point, we can test our function. So we can copy this code here. This is going to be used for a simple test event. Let's go to test. And then let's create a new event. I'll call this my test. I'll just leave hello world here, but then we can actually override with our code here. So we can change this to sort of test one, test two, something like that. And then I can simply save and then run test. And let's see what happens. Okay, so there's nothing wrong with the code. The code is working at this stage. Nothing is going into a table, of course. We haven't created the table and we haven't sent a request to add information to the table, but we've validated that the function itself is working. All right, so what we can do next, and there's an option here, you could use the command line as well if you wish to for a bit of extra fun. What we'll do next is create our REST API. So this is going to be called DynamoDB Operations. Let's come back to the console, open up API Gateway. And this will be a REST API. So scroll down to where it says REST API and click on build, new API, provide the name. The regional endpoint is fine. So create the API. And what we need to do now is we need to configure our API. We're going to create a resource and make sure you get the correct value. So it's better to come back and make sure that you get all the right values from the document by copy pasting. So the resource will be DynamoDB Manager. So we'll come back and we'll paste that in here next to resource name, and that's going to be under slash. So it's the root. Click on create resource. Next, what we need to do is we're going to create a post method for the DynamoDB Manager resource using a Lambda integration, non-proxy, and enter the function name as Lambda function over HTTPS. Okay, so here what we need to do with the slash DynamoDB Manager selected, click on create method, Lambda function, it's going to be a post because we're uploading information, and then select the function. And then all we need to do is scroll down and create the method. Back in the instructions file, we need to create a table named lambda-api-gateway. Very important that this name is accurate because this is going to be referenced in the code. And for the partition key, use ID in lowercase, and that's a string value. So let's head over to the DynamoDB console. I'll create a new table, provide the name, and then for partition key, ID in lowercase, and that's a string. And then all the defaults are fine. We just create the table. So that should take just a few seconds to create. We are essentially now ready to test. So what we're going to do is we're going to go back to our REST API. We're going to go to the DynamoDB Manager resource and choose the post method. And then we're going to use the method execution pane to run a test event. And then we're going to add this information in. Okay, so let's copy this information. So let's go back to the console. And what we need to do here is make sure that we have the post method selected. And then scroll down here, you can see method request, integration request, etc. Just use this arrow to get to the test. Okay, so click on test, leave query strings blank. We're going to head down and headers as well. And we're going to head down to request body and then run test. And let's see what happens. Well, we get a status code 200. That is a success. And we have an execution log here as well. So the best way to check this out is to head over to our DynamoDB console, click on explore items, and then select Lambda API Gateway table. And there we go, we have an entry. And you can just rerun that test event as many times as you wish to and change the values, and you'll end up with additional items. So for example, let's just head back up and we'll just change this somehow. We'll give this a 10 and then run test again. And now if we need to rerun the scan on the table, so just run, and now we've got two items in the table. So for this exercise, we didn't even deploy our API to a stage. We're literally just running a test event. So it's a very good way of validating your API is working before you build the application front end, if you can supply the relevant request in a format that is being expected by the Lambda function. So that's it for this exercise. All you need to do to clean up, delete your table, delete your API, delete your Lambda function.